Hello and welcome dear students. My today's lecture is on groundnut, in which we will be discussing about botany, cultivation and economic importance. Groundnut is an annual low-height, densely branching legume cultivated for its edible seeds. The plant is known by various vernacular names such as mungfali, peanut, monkey nut, earth nut and China badam, etc. It is actually not a nut but a legume with underground pods as fruits. Now we will analyze its taxonomy and classification. Groundnut is a self-pollinating amphiploid or allotetraploid with 2n is equal to 40 plant of the family Fabaceae with a genome size of 2891 MBPs. When Linnaeus in 1753 first named the cultivated groundnut as Arecus hypogea, it was only member of the genus. Later many species in the genus were discovered, but most of them were invalidly described. Many workers including Bentham, Chevalier and Hermann studied the taxonomy of the genus and tried to consolidate its systematic position. These treatments however are now largely outdated because of the number of new taxa that have been collected and described in the past 40 to 50 years. The genus was in a state of confusion until 1994, when Crapo, Vikas and Gregory published a taxonomic revision of the genus, recognizing 69 species in 9 sections, generally described on the basis of morphological characters and life cycle attributes. Out of these 96 species, Arecus hypogea is by far the most economically important species in this genus. However, some other species like Arecus velocilicarpa and Arecus stenosperma are also being cultivated for their seeds. The species as classified under different classification systems is summarized as by Bentham and Hooker. They classified Arecus hypogea into genus Arecus, order Roselles, series Calciflori, subclass Polypetli and class Dicotyledons. Takhtajan classified Arecus hypogea into genus Arecus, suborder Stylosanthini, tribe Echinomini, subfamily Papilionidae, family Fabaceae, order Fabales, superorder Fabaceae, subclass Rosaidae, class Magnoliopsida and division Magnoliophyta. The angiosperm phylogeny group in their third classification classified Arecus hypogea into species Arecus hypogea into genus Arecus, familia Fabaceae, ordo Fabales, clades Urosids, clades Rosids, then core Eudicots, then into Eudicots, finally into angiosperms and Regnum plantae. Arecus hypogea consists of two subspecies, a subspecies hypogea and subspecies fasticata, each with two botanical varieties. Those of subspecies hypogea are variety hypogea and variety hirsuta, and those of subspecies fasticata are variety fasticata and variety vulgaris. However, in 1994, Crapo, Vikas and Gregory proposed two new varieties of subspecies fasticata in addition to the existing ones, namely variety Peruviana and variety Equatoriana. There is considerable variation in the two subspecies of Arecus hypogea in the pattern of their habit. Subspecies hypogea, that is runner type, is characterized by a more prostrate growth habit without flowering branches on the main stem. It includes the Virginia type groundnuts. Subspecies fasticata, that is bunch type, is characterized by an erect growth habit with flowering branches on the main stem. It includes the Spanish and Valencia type of groundnut. Now we come to the origin and geographical distribution of the species. The center of origin of the cultivated groundnut has been discussed many times but still not clear. It is believed to have originated in South America, particularly Bolivia, Peru, Brazil and northwestern Argentina. Brazil has been generally recognized as the major center of diversification of the genus. However, Grapovicas believed that Arachis hypogea probably originated in Bolivia and northwest Argentina on the eastern slopes of Andes Mountains. In addition to this, 6 secondary centers of diversity are also being recognized, which are Guarani region, then Goas and Minas Gerais in southwestern Brazil, number 3, Rondônia and northeastern Mato Grosso in western Brazil, number 4, Bolivia, eastern slopes of Andes, number 5, Peru, and number 6, northeastern Brazil. It is an ancient crop of the New World and was widely grown in Central and South America, Mexico, and West Indies. Spanish and Portuguese traders are believed to have carried the plant to the Old World. 2-seeded varieties are considered to be native of Brazil, from where they have been introduced to West Africa. The 3-seeded variety has its origin in Peru, from where it is believed to have been taken by Spaniards across the Pacific to Philippines, from where it was introduced to China, Japan, Malaysia, Indonesia, India, and East Africa. At present, the groundnut is grown in almost all the tropical and subtropical countries of the world, and also in some warm, temperate regions between 40 degrees north and 40 degrees south latitudes, especially in India, China, West Africa, and Southeast United States. Dear students, now we analyze morphological description of the species. Arachis hypogea is an annual herb, reaching to a height of 0.6 meters. The species includes both runner and bunch type plants. Stems are erect, procumbent or decumbent, 30 to 70 centimeters tall, yellowish green, pubescent and glabrescent. Leaves are stipulate, usually arranged spirally, four-foliate with 2 opposite pairs of leaflets. Each leaflet is elliptic, obovate and rounded at both base and apex. Petiole is 5 to 8 cm long, covered with long flexus trichomes. Bracts are 2, lanceolate shaped with acuminate apex. Flowers are about 5 to 15 mm in diameter, borne axillary, solitary or in groups of 2 to 3, sessile or shortly stalked after growth of a tubular hypanthium just before enthesis. Calyx is membranous with tube 4 to 6 mm elongating with flower development, 5-lobed. Corolla is yellow to golden, usually with red nerves, vexillum spreading with emarginate apex, wings oblong to obliquely ovate. Keels distinct, long, ovate, shorter than wings, inflexed with apex acuminate or beaked. Stems 10, all joined, of which 2 stems generally sterile. Anthers 8, of which 4 elongate and subbasifics, alternating with 4 short and versatile. Ovary subsessile, oblong, perigynous, 2 to 5, rarely 7 ovuled. The tip of the ovary grows out from between the floral bracts, bearing with it the dried petals, calyx lobes, and hypanthium, thereby creating a unique floral structure called peg. The peg quickly turns down towards the soil and thrusts its tip with its ovules several centimeters into the soil, where the tip turns horizontally and develops into pods. Fruit is an indehiscent legume, oblong, inflated 2 to 5 into 1 to 1.3 centimeter, thick-walled, reticulate veined with 1 to 4, rarely 6 seeds. Seeds are oblong to irregularly ovate, 5 to 10 mm in diameter, with testa thin and various colored, like pink, red, purple, brown, yellow, white, are marked with small purple dashes. Let's discuss its cultivation. Groundnut is one of the major oil seeds and food legume in the world. As a short season tropical annual legume, it can be adopted in environments with low rainfall availability and distribution. It is usually cultivated as a kharif crop, being sown from April to May to June to July, depending upon the onset of monsoons. All commercial peanuts are propagated from seeds, but vegetative propagation using cuttings is also possible. Virginia type peanuts have dormancy period, whereas Spanish and Valencia types are little or no seed dormancy. Sowing high quality seeds in a well prepared moist seed bed is essential for crop establishment. Fully mature groundnut pods intended for sowing are often hand shelled 1 to 2 weeks before sowing. Seeds prior to sowing may also be treated with fungicide such as thyrum to control seedling diseases. The spacing between plants depend on the type of cultivar. Small seeded Spanish types are spaced at 60 to 75 cm between rows and 10 cm within the rows, and large seeded Virginia types are spaced at 75 to 85 cm between the rows and 15 to 20 cm within the rows. Groundnut seeds are sown 1 to 1.5 inches deep into the soil. Groundnut plants begin to bloom about 30 to 40 days after emergence. After pollination and fertilization occurs, the stalk, that is peg, below the fertilized ovary elongates and covers downwards. It takes about 10 days for the peg to penetrate in the soil. A week after soil penetration, the peg tip enlarges and pod development begins subsequently. The fruit matures in 9 to 10 weeks with favorable temperature and moisture conditions. Since the peanut plants flowers over several weeks, all the pods do not mature at the same time. Groundnut should preferably not be grown in the same field consequently for more than 3 years to limit damage by soil-borne diseases, nematodes, and weeds. Therefore, the crop is generally cultivated as intercrop in rotation with wheat, sorghum, bajra, cotton, peas, chilies, and onions, etc. The selection of groundnut variety for a locality depends largely on the length and time of the growing season. The bunch type of groundnut matures sooner, that is in 90 to 120 days, than spreading or semi-spreading types, which require 130 to 150 days to reach maturity. Some of the suggested varieties of peanut for home gardens include Pax Vapor Spanish, Early Spanish, Virginia Improved, and Jumbo Virginia. Variety Pax Vapor has large seeds, Spanish is an early variety with small seeds, and Jumbo Virginia has short pods with large seeds. Now harvesting. The crop is ready to be harvested within 3 to 4 months after the foliage begins to turn yellow in late summer or early fall. Generally, entire plants are uprooted by digging up the plant with a spreading fork and carefully shaking off the loose soil to remove the pods. Plants are dried by hanging the plants in warm, dry places. After the plants have dried, for 1 to 2 weeks, peanut pods are pulled from the plants. Once dried, the peanuts are put in mesh bags and stored in rain-protected, cool, well-ventilated places until utilized. Now we analyze some ecological factors conducive for growth of the groundnut. Climatic conditions such as temperature and rainfall significantly influence the groundnut production. Warm and moist conditions are very favorable than cool and wet climate, which result in slow germination and also increase the risk of seed rot and other seedling diseases. Peanuts are frost sensitive and require a minimum of 120 frost-free days to reach maturity. Temperature is a major environmental factor that determines the rate of crop development. Temperature above 35 degrees centigrade inhibit the growth of the groundnut. Optimum mean daily temperature to grow is 30 degrees centigrade and growth ceases at 15 degrees centigrade. For rapid emergence, soil temperature about 21 degrees centigrade is needed. While the plants require a certain amount of moisture, excess of water is detrimental to its growth. Adequate and well distributed rainfall during the growing seasons, especially during flowering, pegging and pod formation stages, is essential for maximum yield and quality of groundnut. Groundnut is grown in areas receiving 600 to 1500 millimeters of rainfall. A dry period is required for ripening and harvesting. Once the pods are mature, rainfall adversely affects the crop, as some cultivars have very brief dormancy and germinate under suitable conditions. Groundnut crop grows best on light, sandy, well-aerated soils, which facilitate the developing fruit to get buried in the soil. Sandy loam, and well-drained blake soils, well supplied with calcium and moderate amounts of organic matter, are good for the crop. Heavy and stiff clay soils are generally undesirable. It's important to maintain near to neutral pH levels of the soil. Now we discuss some common diseases and pests of groundnut. Groundnut is a principal oilseed crop that suffers severe yield loss due to insect pests and diseases at different stages of crop growth. Many defoliating caterpillars such as Spodoptera litura, Helicoverpa armigera and Amsecta albis triga, groundnut leaf miner, Aproerima medicilla, sucking pests like Aphis crassivira, jessids and thrips attack the crop and cause severe economic losses. Early and late leaf spots, rusts and blights are serious foliar diseases of the groundnut. Similarly, various types of soil-borne rots and viral bud necrosis diseases are other common diseases. When groundnut is grown in poor soil under inadequate growing conditions, the crop becomes highly affected by these pests and diseases. Groundnut rosette virus transmitted by the Aphis crassivira, endemic to sub-Saharan Africa and widely prevalent in Ghana, Nigeria, Malawi and Zambia, is the most destructive disease of the groundnut, leading to 30 to 100% yield loss. Early sowing at high plant population densities and by giving complete soil coverage as quickly as possible and restricting the movement of aphids control the spread of groundnut rosette disease. Another important problem in groundnut production is the aflatoxin contamination by fungi aspergillus. Aflatoxin has immunosuppressive properties and studies have revealed a positive correlation between aflatoxin intake and incidence of liver cancer. Now we see groundnut producing areas of the world and annual production. Groundnut is grown on nearly 23.95 million hectares worldwide with a total production of 36.45 million tons and an average yield of 1520 kilograms per hectare. Developing countries in Asia, Africa and South America account for over 97% of the world groundnut area and 95% of the total production. As you can see in histogram, the production is concentrated in Asia, that is 50% of the global area and 64% of the global production, and Africa with 46% of the global area and 28% of the global production. Between 2000 and 2009, the annual global production increased marginally by 0.4%, the area increased by 0.3% and yield by 0.1%. The major groundnut producing countries of the world are China, India, Nigeria, Senegal, Sudan, Burma and the United States. These countries account for about 70% of the global production of the groundnut. India is only next to China, both in regard to the area and the production of the groundnut in the world. Groundnut is the major oilseed crop of India. It grows in 11 states in the country in an area of 7.6 million hectares with a production of 7.8 million tons of pods per annum. 70% of the area and 75% of the production are concentrated in the four states of Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. The average productivity of groundnut in India is about 1000 kilograms per hectare and is stagnating for the last several years. Now we see oil extraction from peanuts. Hydraulic pressing, expeller and solvent extraction are some of the general methods of extracting oil from the seeds. When hydraulic pressing is used, it is followed by hot solvent extraction for nearly total recovery of the oil. Expeller extraction relies on friction and pressure within the expeller, which causes the meal to heat, thus facilitating the oil extraction process. This process removes approximately 50% of the peanut oil. The remaining oil is extracted using hexane, which is later removed through an evaporation condensation system. Solvent extraction involves petroleum hydrocarbons or other solvents. This method is accomplished in closed system where oil is removed and solvent reclaimed for reuse. Extracted oil is refined by deesterification with sodium hydroxide to neutralize the free fatty acids. Washing with water at about 82 degrees centigrade to remove the sodium hydroxide and then bleaching with bleaching clay at about 100 degrees centigrade under reduced pressures. The refined oil is then deodorized by heating under vacuum and blowing superheated steam through the oil. The purpose of the refining process is to remove non-triacyl glycerol components, including free fatty acids, non-hydratable phosphoacyl glycerols, sterol pigments, waxes, hydrocarbons, and other compounds that may be detrimental to the flavor and oxidative stability of the refined oil. Aqueous enzymatic oil extraction is another eco-friendly extraction process. It is based on simultaneous isolation of oil and protein from oil seed by dispersing finely ground seeds in water and separating the dispersion by centrifugation into oil, solid and aqueous spaces. The presence of certain enzymes during extraction enhance oil recovery by breaking cell walls and oil bodies. For peanuts, a multi-step aqueous extraction process has been described with a recovery of about 98%. More recently, the relatively new techniques of enzyme-assisted aqueous extraction has been applied to peanuts with a reported oil recovery of 86% to 92%. Now we see the chemical constitution of the peanut. An average of several types of edible seeds of groundnut generate about 500 calories of energy per kilogram of dry groundnut seeds and constitute about 49.2% fats, which are rich in oleic acid, linoleic acid and palmitic acid. Then 25.8% proteins, 16% carbohydrates, 8.5% dietary fibers and about 6.5% minerals, which include calcium, magnesium, phosphorus, iron, zinc, besides some amount of beta carotene. It also contains small amounts of important vitamins like vitamin A, thiamine, riboflavin, niacin, vitamin B6 and folate. The water content of the fully matured seeds of groundnut is about 6.5% of the total dry weight. The essential amino acids include leucine, phenylalanine, valine, lysine, isoleucine, threonine and methionine in the descending order of their proportion by weight. Now we discuss uses of groundnut. It is an excellent food crop to reduce malnutrition due to rich nutritional properties of its oil and proteins. The groundnuts are consumed in many ways and various forms. They may be eaten raw, boiled, steamed or roasted. They are sometimes eaten as a sweetmeat by coating them with sugar. In the West, they form an important constituent of confections. They are often taken in the form of nut chocolates, candies, and sandwiches. A large number of food products are prepared from the groundnuts. The groundnut flour is becoming increasingly popular in the West. It is by far superior to wheat flour in nutritive value. Groundnuts may be used for preparing nutritive and tasty milk and groundnut butter. In food value and consumption, the groundnut milk is similar to dairy milk and may be used as its substitute. The groundnut milk may be converted into curd. A small quantity of the cow milk curd may be added to the milk and allowed to remain overnight to set. It tastes like milk curd and possesses much of its qualities. Groundnuts are also used as vegetables when the seeds are still tender. They may also be taken in their germinated form. Germination not only renders them more digestible but also enhances their food value, especially in their vitamin B and C contents. The groundnut is particularly valued for its protein contents, which is of high biological value. Proportionately, groundnuts contain more proteins than meat, about 2.5 times more than eggs, and far more than any other vegetable food, except soybean and yeast. The proteins in groundnut are well balanced, except for slight deficiencies in some of the essential amino acids. Groundnut is an important crop valued for oil. The oil is nutritious and widely used as edible oil around the world. Now we see some of the medicinal use of groundnut. Apart from their nutritional value, groundnuts have considerable medicinal use also. Groundnut oil is regarded as an excellent aperient or a mild laxative and emollient, which often softens the skin. Eating fresh roasted groundnuts with jaggery and goat's milk is a very nutritious food for growing children, pregnant women and nursing mothers. It builds resistance against all infections, particularly tuberculosis and hepatitis. Groundnuts or groundnut products have also been reported to be used in the treatment of hemophilia, nose bleeding, and in case of excessive bleeding during menstruation in women. Groundnuts are also considered beneficial in the treatment of obesity by reducing appetite. It has also been reported to have beneficial effects in ailments like diabetes, diarrhea, and teeth disorders, etc. However, there are certain problems also associated with excessive use of groundnut products, such as groundnut allergies, high acidity in the body, supermetoria, and premature ejaculation, etc. Dear students, today we discussed about the botany and economic importance of groundnut. We analyzed its taxonomy, morphological features, origin and distribution, and cultivation practices. We also highlighted the ecological factors necessary for its cultivation, production, and its chemical composition. We discussed some methods of oil extraction and also highlighted some of the common uses. I hope this discussion will make you understand about the groundnut botany. Thank you. Have a good day.